out there and, of course, back home to represent. TNT, let's welcome Trinidad James. All gold, everything. James. Respect that man as one. From what I understand, you're a Williams, right?
Yes.
Yeah, your dad is from, is it Tobago? And your mom from Port of Spain?
Correct.
You were born?
Port of Spain.
Port of Spain General Hospital?
Monto.
Yeah. Where you grew up? Your early formative years before you went across to the
U.S.? That's my question, but it embarrassed me. I ain't sure. I'm so young. And I remember all the details of it. In Port of Spain, you know, around in different area, like, no, I don't want to say the wrong thing. I'm not saying the wrong thing.
Because we're going on the top talk that you're from Monglambert, people say you're from Mondo, people say you're from Mova. I mean, I say I'd ask the man.
I understand. Don't ask the man either. I ask the man family.
What age you left in Montana?
8 years old, 7 years old.
Yeah.
You know, I went to Canada. And the States.
The States? Yeah. What part of the States you touched down first? Because I know you're like you're
New York.
New York first.
Of course.
At what point you made that transition to ATL?
After Florida, New York, Florida, ATL. Mm-hmm. Then South Carolina and back ATL.
Excellent. Before the music stuff, before obviously the success of YouTube and the mainstream success, of course, before you getting signed and all that stuff, what kept you busy? What you get into other than the music?
I ran a clothing store. Sell goods to a men's boutique in Atlanta. I ran it for like 3-4 years, and that's what I was doing. You know, running the store, I started as like, you know, sales associate, and then moved into running the store. And then while I was working there, I just decided to pick up on the music, you know, as another hustle, and it really paid off for me.
It sell off?
Yes, sir.
And you think of ATL, ATL is a place rich in music, it's a place where lots of the big names they come out of ATL. So
right.
I know the music scene there is very lively.
Yes, it is.
Are you taken aback with the success of the buzz that this video you did and this all gold everything? I mean, if you really, I think, you know, I saw it on World Star Hip Hop, and then from there it just went. It was like a YouTube sensation first, and then it became.
No, when World Star first.
When World Star first.
Yeah. And we'll start, we went 6 million, you know, boom, 6-7 million out the gate. And then it really built a buzz because the song was already a song that was buzzing.
In Atlanta?
Yeah, in Atlanta and in different parts, in New York, a little bit here and there. But the video really opened everybody's eyes to like, who's Trinidad James?
Mm.
So, with that being said, the video paid off and started meeting different people. And then people realized I had a project, I just went from there. Like, oh wow, you know, good music.
How come not Trinidad Williams, seeing that Williams is your last name? Why James?
Because before it was Trinidad James, it was Nick James. I was based off of Rick James. Because my style is so different.
Yeah.
Some of my friends in Atlanta, they gave me the nickname Nick James.
Mm.
Or whatever. And when I was in the beginning of making the music, that's the name I was going by. But it was another rapper by the name of Nick James. And I just wanted to have my own identity only. I didn't want to mess up anything he was doing. And I said, well, I'm going to Trinidad James.
Yeah.
You know?
It would turn around good for you because, I mean, you're rapping all over with the red, white, the black.
I have to.
And there's Trinidad's out there and Trinidad's here too. You know, they feel good when they see, you know, that kind of presence.
Right.
Obviously, Nicki Minaj did it. For her sound the alarm.
Right.
And I mean, from what I understand, everywhere you go, you pump with that Trinidad and Tobago flag, right?
Yes. That's my signature. The flag, the first show I ever did in the States, in Atlanta, when I tied my head in that flag, that's the same flag I've been using everywhere I've been.
Mm.
And I've been, you name it, I've been there, as far as in the States, you know? So I just take it and spread that energy, that spirit, wherever we go, you know? Just, and honestly, I want to tell you that. I want everybody to know, not even just Trinidad, just anybody around the world that's not in the United States, but say that. Me putting those flags in the All Gold Everything video, and me wearing the flag all the time, is not to force Trinidad, you know, or for people in Tobago that they have to like Trinidad James because my name is Trinidad and I rip it flat. It is never a forced thing. It's one of those type of things where I just wanted to show where I was born that I never forgot. And I respect being a Trinidadian. I'm very proud to be a Trinidadian. And if nobody in Trinidad never liked my music or never liked me, it's all good. Because I respect and I'm happy to be a Trinidadian. I feel like it gave me an edge on the States, because it's not like I came to Trinidad to try and blow up. I did my thing in the States and then come back home and we shot the video for Females Welcome, which is the next big track on my Don't Be Safe album. And it's one of those type of things where it's not force, it's just showing respect. And my mother teach me, you want to be, the way you want to be treated is the way you treat somebody.
Where's your mom and dad?
In the States.
In the States?
Yeah, my mom's still in London, my father's still in South Carolina.
What do they think about this notoriety, this success?
My father proud, you know, yeah, he used to be a musician, kind of, you know, the music stemmed from him, you know, so he proudly happy, you know, he happy to know that I'm doing something positive in my life, you know, just in general, because I could be doing anything else, and, you know, he's just genuinely happy. My mother, she religious, so, you know, she is back and forth, you know, but at the end of the day, I happy, she happy, and that's all we on it.
In terms of plans for Soca, I know that must have come in your radar, seeing that you're here now for the carnival. You performed at the Marshall Monday, you performed at Ramon. You saw for yourself who's the kind of crowds that come out.
Right.
For the carnival.
Yeah, definitely. Well, you see how they about it. That's why we didn't give them too much. You know, and I didn't want to force it, like, oh, try and set up a big show to do all my music. Because I wanted Trinidadians and just anybody at Rama or at Marshall Monday to understand, to figure out, take the time, who is Trinidadian. Don't just like the person because everybody likes you then. You don't really like me then. You just like him because everybody else likes it. Yeah, I mean, you don't really know them. I mean, you marry a girl just because I tell you, when I get into marry. You don't really know the girl. You marry a girl 3 months later, you're mad, you're upset at me. Because whether I believe my music is good enough, if you listen to it and you don't like it, that's your opinion, I have to respect it. That doesn't mean you're wrong. I love my music, you hate my music. You know who both right? Both of us. Because music is opinionated. You know, so just in general, I want people to, okay, we get here, all go. Alright. People, I was looking, there's people who didn't know it. Not in the head, and there's people looking around like, wow, these people having a good time this month, so let's find out why. So with that, it's almost like a, it's like a project, it's like a problem where you start a starter, where you build a foundation, and you build off of it.
Excellent. Yeah? You ready for that piece? I mean, the music scene in the US is very different. I mean, obviously, when you head back, you mentioned you got your project you're working on, you got a momentum. You ready for that, for the ride?
I mean, I have to be. You know what I'm saying? You have to be. It's one of those type of things where I never ask myself my question. I just wake up. I'm not waking up, and whatever comes, attack it.
That's right.
That's all you can do, man.
That's right.
At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? If it ain't meant to happen, it ain't gonna happen.
Stay for Carnival?
I have to go back to Miami on the Thursday. But I ride it that way, give Trinidad a good taste, and just show people that Trinidad James here for Trinidad.
Got a chance to see family, cousins?
That's what I'm doing these couple of days of our life. I could shoot a big video, I could be big, trust me, we're big. Enjoy that, so family time now.
Prior to this particular trip, when last you came to Trinidad?
2011. When I first came with papers, right? First place I flew out, Trinidad.
You already kind of worried about Trinidad, James, right?
Well,
you knew that eight is not, I couldn't remember what that was.
Well, I went through a lot of things. You know, whatever, I had a head injury and everything at 7.
So you already can't
record? I just can't record.
You must find out, man, so people could know. So at least that area could know about Trinidad James. Because I live well in that area.
Well, my family, you can say what it, all my family still live in the same place that we live in New York.
How is that?
Which I don't know. So anybody who know my family who say, like somebody say, like my sister out there right now.
Yes.
My sister still stay in the same place, my auntie still stay in the same place for the most part, or whatever. And so if they say Trinidad James is my nephew or cousin, Bounce his pistol like bro. Hello?
Trinidad Jameson, touch your base. See a traveler's back.
Okay, bye.
All the best, man.
Alright?
All good, everything.
Hey, man.
Yeah, man. Alright, good, I'm good. For real. Take a pause. Yeah, we come back, we touch base with Raymond.